sometimes conservative care just isn't enough and you have to do surgery, correct? It just gets to the point.
Absolutely. And so it depends on the type of condition that we're dealing with. And so let's talk a little bit about, you know, disc herniation. And so what we call minimally invasive for a herniated disc, we call that a lumbar microdiscectomy. And so that has to do also with where the level, whether we have 5 lumbar vertebrae. And so depending on where that herniation is, that's what we call lumbar 1 to 2 or L5 to S1. So that's just kind of telling us exactly where it is in your spine. So minimally invasive is how we saw in the video, is just a small incision where the surgeon goes in and uses a type of tool where they go in through the muscle, they separate it, and they get to that area where the herniated disc and take that piece of that disc out and make sure that everything is clear, there's no loose material around there, and then, you know, they take that piece out and then they, you know, surgically, you know, give some sutures, and then you have about 1 or 2 inch incision.
Let's look at 5 different things to help you determine when surgery is necessary. And I'm very interested here to find out which one's more common than others and which one you see in your practice more than others. We have x-ray, MRI, imaging, myelography, and a discogram. Out of those 5, which one do you see the most?
The MRI. Definitely the MRI. We see it's a better tool for us to use to determine whether, you know, surgery is needed, exactly where the problem is. It's very specific where it's causing some of the damage, and so it's a lot more of a specific exam.